I'm sure you've seen people use this vertical monitor setup before. I have too. I was always curious how it would be like to use it on a daily basis. So even though I have always been a normal landscape monitor user, I switched my monitor to this portrait vertical orientation and have been using it for a few days. People usually say this is a productivity-based setup, you know, meant for work and long hours of programming, stuff like that. I'm not a programmer myself, but I do occasionally write some long articles and spend considerably long amount of time browsing online, so maybe this vertical setup would be cool. It was pretty easy for me to do this. If you remember, I have this monitor arm installed on my desk. If you haven't seen that video, you can check it out there. It's a pretty cool thing. This monitor arm allows me to keep my monitor any way I like without any additional cable management in a few minutes. But let's get to the real question. Is this setup really productive? Well, it depends on what kind of work you do, and for the advertised work that they say, you know, productivity and long hours of typing, whatever, I think it is. My 27-inch monitor provides plenty of vertical room in this orientation, so reading articles and stuff online was pretty much a no-scrolling experience. It was a little tricky with certain apps that do need a landscape orientation, like for example Canva or even an Excel sheet. Obviously, because of its vertical orientation, you could only see a couple of horizontal columns at a time, so it involved a lot of horizontal scrolling. It's not that big of a deal, but most of the computer mice that we use are designed for vertical scrolling. They don't usually have a horizontal scroll wheel. Yeah, I know that there are some mice that do have that, and if you're using something like an external touchpad, then it becomes way easier. So I had to move those tabs to my laptop screen and use them in a landscape orientation. I know that the laptop screen is way too small compared to this giant monitor on the side. Ideally, you should have another monitor in landscape orientation. I'm actually thinking of getting another monitor for myself. Like, this one on the side is pretty good, but maybe for a main monitor I should get another 1440p one that matches the laptop's display. I mean, I don't really need all that hardware, it's pretty overkill for my work, but still it would be cool, I guess. And I think a 24-inch monitor would be perfect to be aligned in a vertical way as opposed to my 27-inch one. This thing was a bit too big for my liking. That's what she said. I have pretty long arms, so the place where I keep my mouse was kind of interfering with the bottom of the monitor. And if I raise it up a little bit, the top of the monitor would get so high that I literally have to bend my neck to see the top tabs and stuff. So from my past 2 weeks of experience, I can say that having a 27-inch monitor as a landscape one and a 24-inch monitor on the side as a vertical orientation would be the best choice. The dilemma that I'm facing is that I want to keep my setup as minimal and as mobile friendly as possible, meaning that if I want to carry this to another place, I should be able to do it fairly easily. Now, I know that it's kind of a lost cause with a giant 27-inch monitor that I have, but I'm not sure if I want to limit my mobility even more by getting another one. Well, this was a fun experience, and this vertical orientation is actually useful for my kind of usage, so I'm gonna keep it like this on my setup. And I know a lot of you have been asking me for a setup tour. Well, there isn't really much to show. And as you saw, the main reason why I got this monitor arm in the first place was because my setup keeps changing. I keep on changing the orientation and the layout depending on my mood and my interests. I'll give you a more detailed view if you want to, so let me know if you'd like to see that. And in the meantime, if you'd like to replicate this setup, I'll leave all the links to these products in the description so you can check it out. If you have an interesting setup like this or an idea, share it with me on Discord. Link is in the description.